I'm excited, Paula. Well, you and I go back a long time, but what I basically want you to ask is, could you tell the people your story a little bit and why you are still, after all the success you had in this industry, and in particular, why you've chosen Jeanette?
Oh, I'd love to. You know, first of all, I want to tell everyone I am in the transformation business.
Well, Malcolm just told us that.
I know. Scott let me listen to Malcolm, so I was just following up on Malcolm. Didn't he do a great job?
Yes.
I love him, and he just has a big heart, so he's a great guy. Anyway, I was making a comment based on his training. Second of all, before I start, I want to congratulate Fred for his position with Jeanette. We're so fortunate to have him. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, absolutely, yes. Thank you.
Can everybody hear me?
Yes!
Anyway, I've known Fred for, oh my gosh, Fred, for how long? 15 years, 20 years?
Yeah, you'll just say 10, makes me feel better.
Okay, and Fred, we go way back, and when I heard that Fred came on board, I thought, oh my gosh, now we're going at, this is going to be great for all of Northern Europe, so, and it's great for Jeanette, so congratulations, Fred. Anyway, I am going to be in Rome, and I hope many of you are going to be in Rome, and because I can't wait for that event. I mean, next week, and I look forward to seeing all of you. For those of you that are new, or some of you that do not have never met me, my formal background is college teaching. I used to teach at a major university in the United States, in a state called Ohio, and I had bought into that idea that the more I would learn, the more I would earn. So I got my undergraduate degree, then I got my master's degree, then I was almost finished with my PhD, and a colleague had asked me if I'd like to make some extra money during this summer, and I said yes, and it was my first introduction to network marketing. And never heard of network marketing. The company I was involved with was Amway, never heard of Amway. And I was so convinced when I saw this business plan, I saw it on a whiteboard, I saw circles on a whiteboard. I was so convinced that this could be the answer to so many people's financial difficulties, you know, getting out of a job they hated, getting out of a debt, putting their kids to school. I thought everyone would see it the way I saw it. And my first goal was to buy a house because I couldn't afford it on a teaching salary. And so what was interesting is when I started network marketing, there wasn't, it was at a time when it wasn't so, the path wasn't as clear as it is today. There wasn't as many books, there wasn't as great of trainers, and I spent a lot of time making mistakes, not going, I spent 15 months going nowhere. So if any of you have been in the business for 15 months and you're not going anywhere, then you're following my path. Now it's time to change. So anyway, my first 15 months was up and down, and I'm going to talk a little bit about that in Rome. But most importantly, here's what I want you to understand. You know, I thought the initial reward of network marketing was financial reward. That's what I thought. But once you reach the financial reward, and then all of a sudden, you realize that the real reward of network marketing is freedom. Because we live in a free society. We believe we're free people, but until you're financially liberated, until you're financially free, you're not free. Because someone tells you, you have to live close to your job, You can only live in a home that your job can afford. You can only drive a vehicle that your job can afford. You can only go on holiday where your job can afford, or how much time you have off of your job. And in the United States, I think it's a little less vacation, at least initially. And so I realized that I wasn't free, but once I had built myself financially free, I could live anywhere. I could, if I wanted to go on holiday, I just ask myself. I look in the mirror and say, would you like to go on holiday? And I go, yes, I can. And I have total freedom. But it wasn't until I helped my first person get their freedom that I was addicted. Because once you help someone else get out of a job they hate, once you help someone else get out of debt, once you help someone change their life, you can't stop. You want to keep going. I will be in network marketing, and I know I look really young because I started young, 40 years, 40 years in June. And I have to tell you, I have changed lives all around the world. And once you do that, you can't stop changing lives. You just want to help somebody else because this is the greatest vehicle I've ever experienced, ever. And so when I walked away from college teaching, it was a decision point for me, but everyone thought I had lost my mind. So when you tell someone about this business and they tell you you're crazy, what are you doing? You know, I know that feeling because I've experienced the way you've experienced it. But when I spent all those years in university and all those years of working on education, and then they say, yeah, I decided to walk away from all of it, everybody's telling me I've lost my mind. Trust me, this is when you've really got your mind. This is when your life will really start. When you have the courage to step off the curb, when you have the courage to not treat this like a hobby, but when you have the courage to actually grab it as your career, as your future, look at how many people you can help on the way. You know, put up your shield against all the naysayers, but know that you're on the right path and move forward. You're gonna make it. And I have to tell you, if I have two pieces of advice, never miss an event. Never. Never miss an event. Events to people like you and I are oxygen. This is our oxygen. You know, we come and we fill up, and we need events to keep us in the game. We need events to move us forward. We need events to help us grow. And you know, I know that somebody today is going to touch your heart. I know that somebody today is going to wake up your head, wake up something in your brain that spurs you on to build a business. So, you know, never miss an event. And my second piece of advice is be all in. Be all in. Don't say I'm going to be in the business once the kids go back to school. Don't say I'm going to be in the business once I finish, you know, spring cleaning the house. What, you know, you need to be all in. It's, you know, I tell people you need to step across the line. You need to step off the curb. You need to be all in. You'll never learn to ice skate if you only put one foot on the ice. You've got to be all in. You've got to cross that line and decide, I'm going to do this no matter what. No matter what anyone says, because there's going to be a lot of dream stealers along the way trying to steal your dream. And they're going to try to steal it because they want to keep you in mediocrity. Because by keeping you in mediocrity, it makes them feel that they're not so bad. But if you move on, it makes them feel for some reason they haven't done enough with their life. And that's not your problem. You have to keep your tunnel vision, stay in the game, be all in, and stay on that path, keep your goals in front of you. And I'm telling you, there is no reason every single one of you cannot be successful here. Because it's not based on age, gender, occupation, experience. It's based on desire. It's based on what you can do with the space between these 2 years. So I look forward to seeing. I'm going to be in Holland in May. I look forward. I want you to come and see me in Rome, because in Rome I'm going to share some breakthrough numbers, some things that really made this business a lot more streamlined for me.
Yeah.
Thank you.